Hi guys, it's me again. I hope you enjoyed those pictures, especially the one from Zimbabwe. This is a warning, I think, for Israel. Israel is in England and America. If you look at the colonies around the world of the British colonies, that tip of Zimbabwe does play a role in the colonization by Israel. Anyway, I do think this is a warning. This is not Project Bluebeam. This is actually from around the sun. I showed you that. And so I do think some strange things are coming. The signs are intensifying. And of course, we have the sign in September that really could be something. People are talking about the solar eclipse in August that precedes our Revelation 12 sign. And anyway, a lot of chatter going on, especially with the real Christians about these very things. Of course, you'll have the serpent up by her ear. This is very key because the serpent had the ear of the woman in Genesis in the garden. It was Adam. Sorry. A lot of people don't like this, but he was the one that changed the narrative. He wanted to be a god. He had to get the woman to come on board with him. Couldn't do this by himself. This is key. The woman represents the church. And so when you look at these metaphors and allegories, it really you can't take a literal interpretation of the Bible without using these allegories and these metaphors along with it, because it holds so much mystery that has been lost. This is like the story of Esau and Jacob. Esau sells his birthright. Didn't Adam sell his birthright? Sure he did. He sold it, boy. He wanted to be a god. He wanted to be possibly the second Adam. Anyway, we're going to talk about Battle of the Serpents. This is important. Uraeus is the symbol in Egypt. That's the cobra on the death mask that I show on their crowns. You have this Uraeus, this cobra. This is a symbol of a risen one. This is the symbol of sovereignty, royalty, divine authority. That's what it represents. These probably are the children in Egypt of Adam. They know the purpose of the serpent, the usage of it, and they're using it. I know a lot of people don't like it, but when I tell you that Adam was the son of the morning, Lucifer, and he falls and becomes Satan. Look at the name changes throughout the scriptures. You have a lot of them. You have Abram who becomes Abraham, Sarai who becomes Sarah, Jacob who becomes Israel, Saul becomes Paul. In Revelations, it says that you will get a new name. You will sing a new song. This is DNA. And so this really has to do with what's going on in, if you want to call it, the human condition between believing and not believing. There is a name change. Jesus calls the Sadducees and Pharisees vipers. He calls them devils. And so there really is a name change going on, and it really is a spiritual thing. And I know this is hard for people, but it's just like the spirit of Antichrist has to do with the spirit of not believing in the Son. You don't have the Father without the Son. This is in 1 John. And so this is the spirit of Antichrist. And so the spirit of Satan has been passed to all humankind through Adam, by one man, sin entered into the world. And so, anyway, look into the name changes. This is significant. This is key. And yes, that spirit of Satan has been placed in you. And this is what you battle. And we'll go through this more as we go along. But anyway, I just wanted you to see those pictures. I'll put some other strange pictures up for you. Just know this is coming around the sun. This is not Project Bluebeam. This really is the Lord trying to get everybody's attention. Something big really is coming. Anyway, Battle of the Serpents. We have, of course, I showed you the mask with the cobra. And there's also a vulture on it. The vulture represents Upper Egypt, the cobra, Lower Egypt. And this is his rule. You know, that's what he's signifying there. God sends in the sons of God, the shepherd kings and priests unto the Lord. He wants to set the people free. And so he's going to battle with Pharaoh over kingship is what's going on. And so Moses and Aaron have the rod, the staff of the shepherd kings. They go to Egypt, and Moses throws it down. It becomes this viper, this serpent. Pharaoh runs and gets his magicians, and they throw their staffs down and they become serpents. And Moses's serpent eats theirs. He's saying there is that he works for the one true God, the God of everything. The I am, that's who Moses works for. And it's so cool, but he's trying to show Pharaoh, these mighty miracles. He even hardens his heart so he can do this. He wants to show everybody who he is. You'll see this when Jesus comes in the New Testament. The man with the withered hand is born so that Jesus can heal him and show mighty miracles to prove who he is. It's so key, but the Old and New Testament really are the mirror image of each other. And anyway, the people are set free. They're in the desert with Moses and they're turning their hearts from God. They're complaining. And so God lowers the hedge of protection around the people and he sends in these fiery serpents to kill them. And again, he's going to show his power, who he is. Now, these could be these flying rods, these seraphim that attacked him, or it could be pterosaurs. Herodotus wrote that he thought it was pterosaurs. They're brightly colored pterodactyl type dinosaurs. I put a picture of one in. They secreted an acid from their pores. If you've got that acid on you, it burned you to death. There was also the rumor that they breathed fire. And that's throughout history about these giant dragons that actually breathed fire. And so that's what Herodotus thought was attacking the people. Then God tells Moses to take a staff and put a brass serpent on it and hold it up and tell the people if they would look at it, that they would be healed. This is very key because this is a foreshadowing event of the cross. But it also is important to know that the serpent, Jesus is described as a serpent. Remember, he says, be wise as serpents and harmless as doves. There really is a type of wisdom attached to the meaning of serpents and divinity. And so, it's not that they're snakes, it's just in the definition. And so it's so cool when you see these things being played out. I've put a picture, of course, of the serpent that's up by the sun. It will be at the woman's shoulder this September, which is very critical. Again, it's up by her ear, not down by the birth canal. It's going to devour the woman in her hearing. Lies. This is how this plays out all the time. Is Satan is the father of lies. And so from the beginning, it was all about lies, all about the ear. Even though the eyes play an important role, your heart is in your forehead, and what's in your heart comes out your mouth. It's all about the head, but it is in the hearing, in the lies, that seems to be the key in all of these things. Anyway, I think I have a picture of the queen. She's got a staff, a rod in her hand. This signifies that she is a shepherd king. She's been ordained by God. She has an orb and with the cross above it in the other hand. This is also, I have seen this above the earth. And so we'll get into more about the royal family and the fact that they are from the tribe of Judah, and Ephraim and Manasseh, you know, are the lost 10 tribes are in Britain and America and the colonies. This really does fulfill the promise given to Abraham about these great nations. And of course, you have Jacob adopted the two boys, Ephraim and Manasseh, and this really is the promise of Christ, these two Gentile nations. It's so cool. Anyway, I don't want to spend too much time on that. But just know that the serpent really means something about divinity, about royalty, and it's nothing to, you know, ooh, it means Satan. The caduceus, you've got the two serpents. I put a picture of that in. I really think that represents the first and second Adam. You've got the staff. You've got the wings, the healing in the wings, of course. That symbol is used in medicine today. It is a Christian symbol. It does not belong to Satan. In fact, Hermes or Mercury hold the caduceus, and that actually means a messenger from God. This was found on the tomb of Joseph of Arimathea in Glastonbury, England, and we'll talk about that sometime. But these symbols have been stolen by the wicked, and they use them against you. They change the word, and they use that against you. It really is about what you hear and see. And anyway, this is their power. We'll talk about Satan worship, and there's no power there, let me tell you. The only power is these powers and principalities. If these men are sitting up in government high places, kings, priests, these are the powers and principalities it is speaking about in Ephesians, and they have money. That's where their power comes from, not Satan. And we'll go through some of this because it's really cool. They're just worshiping stone and wood. Anyway, just know that the name changes in the Bible, they are significant. You need to study this and figure out why God changes their names. Why Adam, Lucifer, son of the morning, is then called Satan. Why Jacob's name is changed to Israel. There is a purpose in changing the name. And of course, like I told you in Revelations, you'll get a new name, a new song, which is DNA. A body that never dies. And boy, we could be bearing down on this. The messages in the sky are warning us of what's coming. I do believe something big is coming soon. Anyway, look up, your redemption draws nigh. The glory of the Lord is in the heavens, And that's what's going on, baby. Anyway, I'll be back. See you later.